A couple of months ago, we discussed exterior lighting. In this video, I would like to talk about lighting in the interiors. Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. If you are new here, my name is Aga and I'm a CG artist. And on this channel, we explore techniques and tools that will help you become a better artist. Today, we'll focus on the topic of interior lighting, so I hope that after this video, everything will be clear for you. But before we start, don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you aren't already, so you are sure you won't miss any future tutorials. Okay, I think we all agree that lighting is crucial in any type of visualizations. But what kind of lighting we can distinguish in the interiors? Let's talk about it now. I will use this bar image from our advanced interior training as an example to make it easier for you to understand what we are talking about. I put the link to the course in the corner in case you want to check it out. So first of all, we have the lighting that comes from the environment. So basically, the skylight and the sunlight. And we can create different effects just from this one type of lighting. If you want to learn more about the types of natural lighting, watch the video where I talk in details about it. I put the link in the corner to the video. Anyways, sometimes natural lighting can be the only source of light in the interior project and it already looks good. We can, for example, create a moody, cloudy image with soft light, or happier and warm visualization with more direct sunlight, and so on. In this example, though, we chose to create a night image. For this reason, we use just a little bit of environmental light that comes from the outside. Because of that, we couldn't stop on this, and we needed to add lots of artificial light that plays a key role here, which we'll discuss in the next points. In interiors, artificial lighting plays a key role. They add the layering effect, they highlight what is important, they add mood and character and atmosphere to the place. They make it warmer or colder. They basically build up the entire interior space. So let's discuss different types of artificial lighting in interiors. As the name suggests, general lighting provides an overall glow to the space. It's rather used for adding functionality, illuminating the space, than for aesthetic reasons. It's typically the direct light that illuminates space from the ceiling. So in our example, there will be a couple of different sorts of lights. Definitely the lighting that comes from the downlights and lighting up the bar area, and all the pendant lights that brighten up the whole space. The important part is that general lighting shouldn't be left by itself, and it works well with other types of lighting. Ambient lighting lots of the time is used as a synonym of general lighting. Even though they have the same main characteristics, they both are used to light a complete area, they have differences. Ambient lighting is indirect and typically softer than the general light. One of the most common examples of ambient lighting is the wall sconce. And in our case, it will be the same. These wall lights add lots of soft light to the space and help to illuminate the area and move around the place. We also have the mood lighting that is used to create an atmosphere within a space. It's typically soft and it's all about diffusing and reflecting light to create a softer ambience. In our bar image, the table lamps on the console and the downlights lighting up the canvas openings in the wall play a key role in creating an atmosphere in the image. Of course, the lighting in general helps with adding a mood to the space, but in terms of the function of the lights, these ones will play the most important role. Task light. As the name says, it's any light that is used to help accomplish a certain task. These lights are typically brighter and stronger, and provide more visibility and detail. In our case, above all, it will be the light from downlights that brighten up the countertop, so the waitress can prepare some cocktails, for instance. Keep in mind that one light feature can fulfill several roles. Like in this example, this light had a role of both general and task lighting. Similar to task lighting, accent lighting has a particular function. It's typically used to highlight a specific feature, a certain object or decoration in the space. In the bar image, there will be, for example, the lights that brighten up the alcohol on the shelves. Also, the lights from the top of the ceiling that highlight the heart of the bar area, the alcohol shelves. Plus, the painting lights that are one of the most common examples of accent lighting. And the lights that focus on the flowers. Accent lighting is more about adding artistic style and aesthetics to the room rather than functionality. Well, based on the analyzed image, you can notice that especially in spaces like bars, restaurants, cafes, etc., we need to use different type of lighting if you want to create an attractive and eye-catchy space. This effect is called light layering, and it is a key if you want to create visualizations at the pro level. Also, if you'd like to learn how to create this image from start to finish, along with many other shots of the bar area, I'd like to invite you to check out our advanced interior training. Click here to check it out on our website. Bye-bye!